What's up, Fire Fam? Hey, Fire Family. It is Ashley here at Fire Intuition, and I am here to do the weekend reading. It is Friday. We have made it to Friday. Yes, it is the weekend. I hope you guys are having an amazing Friday. I hope you guys have an amazing weekend as well. Send you guys lots of love, light, healing, energy, and abundance. XOXO. So let's hop in, my loves. Let's see what's going on. You guys know that this is a general reading. It is a collective reading. It is for all the zodiac signs. So only do take what resonates with you. All right, guys. I'm going to switch it up. But before we hop into the reading, very quick, guys, a couple announcements. The raffle ends on this Sunday, which I believe is the 12th. And you guys know I will be going live on Monday at 12 o'clock to announce the winners to the raffle and to do Q&A. If you guys would love to purchase a raffle ticket, all that information is in the description box below, also pinned in the comments, alrighty? The June box, it is selling, y'all, so thanks again for the love. But for June, I did a Manifest That Shit box, alright? And you guys are going to get these super cute Manifest That Shit socks, super cute. It comes with my Manifest That Shit candle, and this is the candle, y'all. Okay, it comes with Good Vibes Only Sage. You guys are going to get my new Manifest That Shit spray. It does come with my new shimmer body oil. All right, I'm just going to shake it up so you guys can see it. This is just like the sample one. All right, and this is the bottle that it comes in. And then it comes with the Manifest That Shit bath salts. And to top it off, you guys will get a free t-shirt and some shades, okay? So, very quick, these are the three styles that I have for the glasses. You guys will get a pair in your box. So, the style varies, all right? But it will be one of these three. Hey, these are super cute on. All of them are fire, actually. I should have took a picture with the shades on, y'all. And then, these are the last pair. And they will come, you know, like wrapped up and stuff. And then, it comes with the It's All Gucci and Chanel t-shirt. So you guys will get this shirt for free in the box. I took a picture of myself in this shirt and I posted it on the community tab. It's also on my IG and Facebook as well. But you guys will get this shirt for free with the box and the glasses and all this that I just mentioned up here. Well, in this box. So yes, this is the June box, you guys. Super excited. Like I said, it is selling out. So if this is something that you guys want, I would definitely grab it because I only have so many boxes. Available, and you guys know that I offer Afterpay now, so you guys can pay in four. All right, so definitely check that out. If you guys want more information, you guys can go to my online shop, mytearshavehealedmyheart.com. Again, all the information will be pinned in the comments below and also in the description box below. All right, so let's hop in, Fire Fam. Let's see what's going on with you guys for the weekend. What's today? The 10th. So this will be from the 10th through the 12th. Universe, what messages do you have for the collective for the weekend? I'm not going to do finances and career. I'm just going to do love today for the weekend. Alrighty, and let's see where you guys are at in love. I think I am going to switch it up a little bit. I'm going to look into love and see what they want and need from you. And then I think I'm going to do per zodiac sign, okay? I also might pull some ancestor oracle messages and some goddess and gods, and guardian angel oracles at the end, all right? So, let's see what's going on with y'all. Let's see what's going on with the collective in love. Let it be great. Messages for the weekend, June 10th through the 12th in love for all the other signs. All right, let's see. Messages for the collective in love. Messages for the collective in love. Where's your energy and love? Messages for the collective in love for the weekend, June 10th through the 12th. Let's see where you guys are at in love. So we have the Ace of Swords reverse. We have the Ten of Pentacles. And we have the Knight of Pentacles, okay? At the bottom, we have the Ace of Pentacles. So I kind of feel like things are going to work out. The Ace of Swords in reverse is like somebody not saying something, okay? But I do see the Ten of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles. I see you guys still coming together, things kind of like working out. The Ten of Pentacles is family, it's children, it's It could be that you guys are spending a lot of time around each other. This could be you guys focused on your commitment, your relationship. This could be them focused on the commitment or the relationship. But the Ace of Swords in reverse is, it could be miscommunication. It can be a lack of communication. It could be somebody, you know, not communicating something that they've been wanting to tell you. So that can be why the Knight of Pentacles is here, because you see she has a journal and she's writing something. So I feel like somebody hasn't really been, like, it's something that they want to tell you or something that they feel like they need to tell you, or it can be something that you feel like you need or want to tell this person. So let's see what this is about with the Ace of Swords reverse. It doesn't have to be anything bad, so don't get scared, y'all. All right, we're gonna positive energy right here. So all right, so let's see, why is Ace of Swords in reverse for the collective? Let's see, y'all. So we have the Sun here. So yeah, I feel like it's not so bad. Let's see. We have the Ten of Wands. Okay. So I feel like what they really want to tell you is, like, something has just been dragging them or bothering them, or they're stressed about something. But it's like, I feel like when they're around you, like, they're happy, or it's just like they can't wait for this to all be over so that they can be happy, or so you guys can be happy. Because the Ten of Wands is telling me that it's coming to an ending, a completion. It's done. It's something is now behind them. But I don't know why. Let's see. Why is the Ten of Wands here? We have the Queen of Cups. We have the Hermit in reverse. So we got strong Virgo energy here. Let's go into this Hermit in reverse. Let's see what this is about. Why is the Hermit in reverse? Go into the Hermit in reverse. What is this about? Then I'm going to ask what they want to tell you, or talk about the Four of Cups. Okay. So, yeah, so it's just, like, this person just, it's like I said, when they're around you, they're happy, and I feel like something is dragging or bothering them, and I feel like this person is just ready to be happy. The Four of Cups could just be, like, if they've been kind of, like, separating themselves, kind of distant, kind of coming off some type of ways, it's because they're waiting for all of this to be done and over with and be behind them. So, they're shifting out of this energy. I'm not sensing, like, vulnerability or them feeling lonely or, you know, something like that. This is more of like, this situation made me sad. I'm now getting through it or coming out of it. It's now behind me. But I feel like there was like some loss, some hurt, something there. But I feel like now they're going to be in a better energy, a better place, now that something is, you know, coming to a completion or coming to an ending. Okay. But let's see what they want to tell you, or what they were trying to tell you or need to tell you. Okay. You know what? As soon as I pulled these cards, I heard Mary J. Blige, "Share my world, baby, don't you leave." Y'all know I can't sing. "Promise I'll be here whenever you need me near." That's what I heard. That is what I heard. And y'all know I can't sing. But we got the Lovers, the World card, and the Ten of Cups. So, like, they're excited to share their world with you. Like, they're excited to, like, be a part of your life, be in your life. They're excited for all of this. So, like, we've been getting a really good energy in the collective when it comes to love, and I love this. So I just feel like it's not that I feel like this is what they haven't told you. I feel like you guys know, but the Ace of Swords can just be like them waiting for this breakthrough, waiting for this victory of love, waiting for whatever this is to be behind them. Like, wow, y'all make them so happy, or like they're just so happy, like they're like ready, they're just like, I'm ready to share my world with you, like I'm ready to like see how this is, how this feels, how it's gonna be. All right, so let's go into this Four of Cups. Yeah, see, we have justice. Okay, so something is going in their favor, they're getting justice in the situation, but I feel like the process, the ending, whatever they went through, I feel like it just was a lot. It put them through a lot, took them through a lot. Okay, let's even break down this Ten of Wands. Yeah, see the Hierophant. So, and we have it with the Four of Pentacles. So they just had to make a lot of changes. The Hierophant and the Four of Pentacles is making, like, this can just be like life changes, breaking things off, ending things with people, breaking, you know, free from relationships, ending things, coming out of a cycle of like repeated patterns, are coming out of a cycle of like going back and forth to somebody, or going back and forth to this, or dealing with this, or doing that. So it's like the Hierophant is our teacher. So it's like this person is learning a lot and breaking old ways, people, places, things, habits, and It's like they just want to share and commit to you. Like they just want all this with you. So again, this looks very, very, very positive. Oh no, this is not the deck that I wanted. What about you grab this? That's not the deck that I wanted. I'm just grabbing shit. Sorry, y'all. But this looks very like, this is positive. This looks very positive. Yeah, I feel like they can't, it's like they can't wait to show you off to the world, tell everybody about y'all. Like, this looks very positive. Somebody is in the process of releasing an ex, okay, or just got out of a relationship, or just got out of something that, you know, like they're, even if they weren't with that person, they're just releasing the energy of that person. And that can be why the Ten of Wands is there. Just a very heavy energy, like something that was just weighing on them and just, you know, it kept them down. But you lift them up and make them happy. So let's see what this is about. We have make the effort. Yes, great love is worth taking the steps you are guided to take. So this person is making them, putting in the effort. Yes, and we have the Six of Swords. And I feel like you guys are going to move forward in peace. They're finally moving forward with you in peace, and things are going to look up and look better and be great. So yeah, this looks good. Like, I like this. Like the Six of Swords is also like somebody moving on, like moving forward with you, like moving on from something else, moving forward with you. So it's like a lot of peace is coming into this relationship, or a lot of peace is coming into this situation. Are they finally at peace and able to like move forward with you in the way they want to? Let's see. We have children. Children may be involved. Your love life is being affected by children. So let's see what this is about. Oh, yeah, Queen of Pentacles. They have children with somebody. You guys can be dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. But is this telling me that children are involved? And we have a Fool. So I feel like this is going to be different even for their children, because they're going to introduce you to their children very soon. Somebody is planning on introducing you to their children. So look out for that as well. So it's like, this is going to be something new. Let's see how this is going to go. Are you introducing them to your children? But let's see. Why is the Queen of Pentacles here with the Fool? You guys may also be talking about children, or they want a child with you. But for a lot of you, this is them introducing you. Yeah, see the Two of Cups. It's going to happen within like the next 2 months or less. This person is going to introduce you to their children. I feel like it's going to be around somebody's birthday time, or just like around the summer. I'm getting like 2 months, within like 2 months, they're going to introduce you to their children. So you will meet the children, okay? So that's going to be good. Let's see how it's going to go with the children when you meet the children. We have a Hangman. Yeah, see the King of Wands and the other Two of Swords reverse. It's going to go good. I feel like if this person has more than one child, I feel like the oldest child or one of the children are going to, like, they kind of know, like, okay, it's over between mom and dad, or, like, dad's moved on, mom moved on, or whatever, you know. But when it comes to one of the other kids, it's going to be an eye-opener. It's going to be different for them, you know. They're not used to this. It's going to be different, but I don't feel like it's going to be bad. I don't feel like they're going to be all stink or nothing like that. But let's see why this energy is here. They're going to be confused about it at first. Like, they're going to be confused. So one of the children are going to be confused. Like, what's going on? Like, that's not mom, or that's not dad. You know, like, what's going on between y'all? You know, something like that. See, one of them is not going to, like, be up to it or like it. Be comfortable with it at first. But, you know, I feel like that child is just, like, spoiled. They're the youngest. They could be the baby, kind of bratty. They may feel like you are taking like their mother or father away from them, but I don't think it's nothing too serious, nothing you guys should worry about, you know, stress about. But there is going to be one of the kids, like, I don't know, I feel like somebody has two or three kids. One of them are going to be like, you know, kind of like ready or annoyed by it, or like just kind of confused as like what's going on. Like, it's going to be a little bit harder for them to accept it, okay? Could be a fire sign child. And then we have passion. Allow your heart and soul to sing with joy. So there's a lot of passion here. Yeah. Queen of Swords. And I feel like this person has opened you up in a way, because we have a Queen of Swords. So the Queen of Swords is somebody that has like just been through a lot. She definitely like protects her feelings, her heart. She doesn't, you know, give. You know, she's like, nope. She can be kind of cold, push people out. even though she's in the upright. But I feel like when it comes to this person, like, you're, like, really open to this situation. You're really open to them. So that's good. So there's a lot of passion here. This person is making a putting an effort. And then we have children involved, okay? So, and it says children are affected. Children are affecting this relationship. But I don't feel like that's going to be a big, big issue. Like I said, I feel like one of the kids are just going to feel some type of way. And they don't quite understand, like, what's going on, you know? So that's what I'm seeing with that. The overall energy is that your friends help you. So let's see, let your friends help you. We have the Page of Swords in reverse. So I feel like you are, this person is no longer like speaking to friends or talking to people about it, because the Page of Swords is like blocking people out, ignoring what someone has to say, what somebody is telling them. They're not focused on what people have to say or how people feel, or, you know, they're just, it's like they're not listening to that anymore. Because it says ask for and accept support from others, and I feel like they're not doing that anymore with the Page of Swords in reverse. Because they feel like it's just going to lead to, like, gossip or just drama. Or they're just like, like, I'm not telling you guys. I'm good, you know. So, let's see. Yeah, see, they're following their heart, which is good. They're following their heart and how you make them feel. So, they're blocking these people out. You know what I'm saying? So, this looks good. And this person is in love. This person is definitely in love with that King of Cups, okay? So there's definitely a lot of love there, okay? This person is like, you my babe, you're my baby. Like, it's us against the world. Yes. Yes, they are ready to share their world with you. Like, they are ready, like, you know, like, let's do the damn thing. So somebody is definitely ready. That's way too many messages, so I'm not gonna take all those, but let's just pull a couple of messages and see what's going on. True love. I love this. It says the love of your life is entering the picture. So it says the love of your life is entering the picture soon, and you will be happy. So for some of you guys, I feel like your true love is already here, or they could be entering into your life and this is what's going on. So we have true love, okay? So the love of your life is here. We have new love. There is someone on the horizon who is coming into your life soon. So for some of you guys, like I said, this is new love, or this is somebody that's already in your life where there's true love. And we have commitment. This relationship is becoming more serious and could be long-term, okay? So I feel like this relationship is not only going to just be true love and new love, it comes with commitment, and there is a soulmate connection, okay? So it says, your partner is a soulmate who will help you open your heart fully to love. And what do we just see over here? Let me move this out the way. What do we see over here, y'all? I told y'all with the passion and the Queen of Swords. Remember I told you she can be cold, kind of shut down. She can be like an icebox, stuff like that, because she's been through so much. And it says this person is going to help you open your heart fully to love. They're going to help you open your heart to receive this. So their goal, or like your lesson with them, and lessons don't always have to be bad, but this person is teaching you how to open your heart to receive unconditional love, or to receive their love. And it is a soulmate, and this is somebody that is in love with you, and they don't have intentions on like breaking your heart or doing you wrong with the King of Cups. This is someone that is coming in with, like, their love is genuine, okay? And like I said, they're blocking out the naysayers, they're blocking out people, they're not taking that advice anymore, they're not listening to those people, they're not focused on that, they're done with that. Like, they're focused on you guys. So, I mean, this is good. I love how the readings have been, like, super positive, you know? So, that definitely means that the energy in the collective is shifting. So, that's great. That's always amazing. So, yes, y'all deserve this. Y'all deserve this love, okay? There's been a lot of endings, or there will be a lot of endings, because the collective is going into new beginnings, especially astrologically for a lot of people, okay? So, some of you guys are coming out of that karmic cycle, coming out of, like, kind of relationships, are where you guys were like a catalyst in situations, are dealing with a lot of you guys are opening your eyes up to a lot of things, changing your perspective on love, just looking at things totally different. And I just see a lot of love coming in and shifting, even in like personal readings, which is really good, you know, because like sometimes I'll be in here about to pull my weave out, y'all, I'll be like, god damn, can I get a positive reading? So the energy is definitely shifting, okay? So that is very positive. Let's pull a love message for you guys. Let's see. We have the only thing that is real is love. Wow. Shift your focus from the problem back to love. So see, I told you guys, for a lot of you guys, you've been through so much in love. You've been in a lot of problems and issues when it comes to love. And you're shifting your focus and changing your perspective, and you're welcoming in love. See, I told you guys, I can feel it. I knew it. So this looks good, y'all. This looks good. Yay. Let's see what's at the bottom of the deck. We have be in the present and dream of the future. When we dream, everything is possible. So some of you guys are in front of this person. That's why I said this person is in your life. They're already in your life. And what you're focusing on, or what you need to dream of or focus on, is a future with this person. Because anything is possible. So like, if you guys do want marriage or something long term with this person, it's saying you can dream it. Just don't put expectations on it. Don't like, oh, we're together for 2 years and you don't do this, because then you're going to lose the relationship because you're so focused on what you want and what you're expecting rather than going with the flow. And I'll tell you guys, it's from personal experience, and not trying to do myself in it, but like with my fiance, he was one of the first people, actually he was the only person I ever dated where I didn't put expectations on the relationship and I didn't expect anything out of it, and I wasn't like trying to be in control and, oh, if you don't do this, this and that. I just kind of went with the flow of the relationship, and I got way better results. I got way better than any other relationship because I didn't put expectations, you know? And sometimes when we have expectations and they don't go as planned, or our expectations don't unfold the way we want to, we get hurt in the process because we expected it, so we put it in our mind and our heart, and it affects us. And then we get mad and upset, and they're like, so why are you so upset or mad that it didn't work out, or why are you so upset? They don't understand, because you already put that expectation on that person or on the situation, rather just like just seeing where it can go. Okay, so love this. Okay, so it's saying like, dream of the future, dream of what you want with them. Just don't put expectations on it, and it's gonna happen. Okay, so that is looking good, y'all. I think I'm gonna end it here. I'm gonna pull a card and see what your ancestors want you guys to know, or you know, like what message is gonna come out from your ancestors. I'm using the ancestor spirit oracle cards, and then I'm gonna pull per sign, and you know, just kind of see like what the energy is around you guys. Okay, so let's see. And I love how these cards got fire on it, because I'm fire intuition. I just peeped that. I'm like, oh, these cards are nice and fiery. Yes, ancestors, come through. All right, so ancestors, what message do you have for the collective? I just wanted one. That was like three. So just give me one message for the collective for today through Sunday. Today is June 10th through the 12th. What message do you have for the collective ancestors? What do they need to know? Or what do you want them to know? What do they need to know? Let's see. Okay, so we have nature, spirits. So let's see what this is about. You have nature. Oh yeah, they don't have a number on it. Let's see. Okay. So it has a meaning, and it has a lot of different things. Okay. So, all right, this is kind of deep. So I'm going to read a couple different parts. It's not going to sound broken or anything like that, but I'm just going to point, like read what I feel like is important in the message, okay? So it's saying under the ancestors part. So it says, sit quietly, physically protect yourself. Close your eyes and pay attention to what you feel. You may be surprised at what you experience. You may even have seen light orbs floating around you with your physical eyes or your third eye. See if you notice any movement or shadows around you at this time. Be open to receiving messages, okay? So what it's pretty much saying is that for some of you guys, you may have been seeing like orbs. You guys may have seen like lights or things flashing around you. It could even be like, you know, like sometimes I tell you guys, like if I'm in here reading, I'll see like little lights or, you know, things flash or whatever. To me, I know that's my mom. So it doesn't scare me, but it said like you guys might see lights around you, some flashes, some orbs. And what else spoke to me? Damn, it was something else I was about to say. It'll come to me. So it says, the meaning says, pay attention to what you see and sense when you are out in nature. So like when you're out and about, you know, it can be like for the day. I was about to say, and then pictures. If you guys are outside and you're taking pictures and you guys see a light or something flashing in your picture. Like I told you that one day when I took my picture and I seen like that light shine down and I was just talking to my mom in the car, that was like a, you know, a sign for me that that was her. So that's what I was going to say. Like, look at your pictures too, guys. You know, especially if your window's open, if you guys are outside and there's like a like sun or like light in your picture and stuff, that definitely is them. That's your ancestors, okay? So it says, pay attention when you guys are out. It says, as wild as it sounds, you are being called to connect with nature spirits in your area. Respect the respect the wilderness as a home for being seen and unseen. This card may suggest someone doesn't want to be disturbed. Respect their space and let them come to you. So for others of you, I feel like you keep trying to call on your ancestors or calling somebody in. They want to be left alone right now, and they feel like when the time is right or when it's good for them, they're gonna come to you. So some of you guys that have been trying to connect to your ancestors are trying to connect to the other side, and you just don't feel like you're connected with them. It's not because they don't want to connect with you. They need their space right now. They could be evolving on the other side. They can just be doing spiritual work, a lot of things that they are dealing with on the other side. But it's like they are going to come to you, and when they come to you, you're going to see like a light flash, some orbs around you, like I said, a light in your picture. You might be like even driving and you're just like, dang, like it's so sunny, like the sun is in my eyes. You know, I don't know if you guys ever like drove in a car and like you're driving and like the sun hits your eyes and you instantly start like crying. Like not like boohoo crying, but you can't control your tears and stuff like that. That's them coming to you. So I feel like whoever it is, they're healing on the other side and going through stuff. And it's like every time they come to you or whenever they come to you, I feel like it's at a time where like you may be going through something, you're healing through something, or it just comes just out of the blue, okay? But they only come to you at certain times because they need their space right now to continue healing and growing and evolving on the other side, okay? Remember, just because they're on the other side doesn't mean that they are, you know, healed and everything is just great and better. Like, you know, of course the other side is, in my opinion, you know, but I'm just saying, but they are still doing work and stuff like that, you know? But let's see, let's pull another message from your ancestors and see what they want y'all to know. So a lot of you guys, you need to go outside and connect. Maybe you guys are still disconnected and you're trying to reach them. But I feel like for others of you, they're only going to reach you or connect with you when you're out in nature. All right, so let's see. We have family connections. Respect people, kinship. So family connections. So let's see what this is about. And then we are going to go in per sign and see what additional messages spirit has for you guys. Okay. Okay, so family connections, it says, it's time to reconnect with your family. You don't need to live with or spend a lot of time with them, but perhaps you could call or visit a family member. Your family doesn't have to be biological. They could be your adopted family or friends. Sometimes our biological families are no longer part of our lives, and that is okay. It is important to create your own family in whatever way suits you. You may even view your pets as your furry children or family. This card can also be a sign that family members passed away, are living, are trying to contact you. This card can appear when unsolved negative feelings are associated with a family member. This is a prompt that it is now time to heal that relationship. Try not to carry around the pain from your past anymore. Do not feel guilty for wanting to move forward in your life. You may need to distance yourself from the energy of a family member, and that is okay. Look after yourself and focus on surrounding yourself with people who love, honor, and treat you with the respect that you need and deserve. So I love this because for some of you guys, what your ancestors, your family, they're telling you that there is a family situation between you and someone and it needs to be healed. There are some negative feelings. It's something that's unresolved. It's something that doesn't sit right with you. And it's saying that you don't need to carry that pain around anymore. And do not hold on to any guilt or feel guilty for wanting to move forward in this relationship. So I guess I reconcile your differences. Tell this person how you feel. If they don't accept it, that's fine. But move on. You did what you had to do. You said what you had to say. You told this person, look, I forgive you. I'm healing. I'm ready to move on. If they don't accept it, that's on them. Don't feel the guilt. Don't be in regret. It's time for you to move forward. Your ancestors actually want you to move forward from this because they see how bad it is affecting you and hurting you. and they feel like you deserve more respect out of this, you know, situation, or you just deserve respect in general. So for some of you guys, it could be that maybe your closest friends are people that you have met throughout your life. You are more connected and have a better relationship with them than you do your family. But there is a family member that passed over that is your ancestor that does not like the way a family member or a child or somebody around you or close to you in your family is treating you. And they feel like you deserve the utmost respect, and they feel like you should be treated better, and that it is best that you just distance yourself and move away from this person or this family member and no longer carry the pain and heal from it and move on and move forward. Okay? So deep messages for the ancestors and what your ancestors have to say and what they want you to know. All right? And at the bottom, we have be thankful. So they want you to show gratitude, appreciation, and they want you to be in harmony. All right? So those are some deep messages, y'all, especially the family one, okay? So I feel like whoever this is that you're not getting along with in your family, or you're having a hard time moving forward, or, you know, healing from a relationship, I feel like whoever your ancestor is was around when this happened. So they know the whole story, they know the whole situation, and they don't like it still on the other side. They're ready for you to move on and move forward and just be over with the situation. Because I feel like the other person is just not going to change who they are, how they are right now, and they don't want to see you suffer and be in pain or allow this to, you know, hold you back. All right, so let's go into the signs. Actually, I'm gonna pause it real quick and I'm gonna come back because I'm gonna clear this out, and then I'm gonna pull per sign and just see what additional messages spirit has for you guys in love. And we are going to start at the beginning and go to the end. So we're gonna start with Capricorn. Okay, I'm gonna go from Capricorn all the way to Sagittarius. All right, so give me 1 second, guys. I want to clear this out and I'll be right back, y'all. All right, I'm back, y'all. So I am about to pull per sign. Like I told you guys, I am starting with Capricorn all the way through Sagittarius. All right, it would be great and I would be appreciative if you guys timestamped, because I don't want y'all coming in the comments talking shit, complaining, sending me no goddamn email like, oh, you didn't timestamp, other readers do this. I'm not every other reader. So guys, let's keep it cute, okay? So you just either listen to the message or you don't, timestamp, whatever. If you don't, you don't. If you do, you do. But please don't stress me out on this good ass Friday, sending me emails and texts telling me, oh, what time did I do the Virgo part? Just go back and listen, or hopefully another Virgo timestamps or whatever, y'all. Y'all just make things so hard, and just, not all of y'all, I'm not gonna say all of y'all, but some people just make it so hard and so difficult, you know, when it shouldn't be. So I'm just shuffling up these cards and we're gonna hop in and pull some additional love messages for you guys. All right, let me shuffle up this deck as well, because I'll be pulling from both. All right, I'm just gonna pull a couple cards and see where you guys are at in love. Any additional messages that spirit has for you guys in love, and that would be it, y'all. All right, so we starting with Capricorn. All right, let's see, universe and spirit, what additional messages do you have for Capricorn in love for this weekend, or whenever the collective hears this reading? And Capricorn is starting at 33:25, so I will give y'all that. Okay, so let's see. 33:25 for Capricorn. Let's see. Additional messages for Capricorn in love. Okay, so Capricorn, it looks like you guys are coming out of a relationship. Something is ending. It looks like you guys are no longer arguing, communicating, really talking to somebody. Something just didn't work out and you guys are finally accepting that. Six of Pentacles could be that you're, like, you have pulled back your energy and you no longer want to put energy into that because something is an imbalance with the Six of Pentacles in reverse. So you just don't feel like the situation suits you anymore. So this can be that you are no longer going to give in or put into this relationship. Somebody could also be mad about something financially when it comes to the relationship. So maybe they needed you financially, maybe you needed them financially, but somebody is upset about some type of financial matter. But it looks like something has ended, all right? Somebody is just like, no. They no longer want to be a part of a relationship anymore. So let's go into the Six of Pentacles in reverse. We have the Page of Swords in reverse, and we have the Five of Cups. So yeah, I feel like at the same time there is some sadness here, but I feel like you're getting over it. you will be out of that energy very soon. The Page of Swords reverse is telling me like you're blocking this person out. You're blocking out what this person has to say, what people are saying, because in the Five of Swords, we have a lot of different people, even though it's in reverse. So maybe this blocking out what people are saying or what people have to say, this is you just like doing your own thing and allowing yourself to move forward in a, because you feel like it's best to just do that. So we have patience. Love is patient and kind always. And we have pay attention to red flags and signs are cautioning you. Yeah. So there was a situation that you were in and it's like you now see the red flags. Like you've been warned. You've been seeing the red flags. Okay. And I feel like that's why you're moving out of the situation. Now we have patience. You have found someone in that you're with now or that you will soon meet. And they're going to be very patient. Or you're going to be very patient with them. Or you guys are going to be patient with each other. Okay. So it's kind of like you're going to be with somebody or get with somebody that just understands you, all right, and love. But they're going to be, like, very patient, okay? And my hands are itching, and I'm trying not to. Woo, both of them are. It's crazy, okay? So we did Capricorn. What's next? Aquarius. Let's see, Aquarius. We have the Eight of Wands. We have the Five of Pentacles in reverse, and we have the Justice card. So somebody wants to come back and make things right, Aquarius. You're going to get a lot of communication over the weekend, or you'll hear from somebody in the coming days. They're going to be doing a lot of talking, like a lot of talking. It could be a fire sign. They might talk your head off, telling you this, telling you that, telling you how they want to make things right. All right, somebody, there is some papers here. So for some of you guys, somebody is coming to you with some papers, some documents, because they finally got a divorce. They're finally ending something. The lease is finally over. They're finally done and out of something. And they feel like they can really move forward with you. And you guys can really, you know, go towards, you know, what you guys were wanting. Like, you know, how am I trying to say it? Like, I'll just say this situation can now go in both you guys' favor to where you guys can be together. But let's see why this Five of Pentacles is in reverse. Ace of Pentacles in reverse in the Nine of Cups. Yeah, you were waiting for a commitment or an offer, and that's what they're coming in with, okay? I feel like also with the Ace of Pentacles in reverse, it's saying, like, the offer is coming in, but it's just saying, like, don't jump straight into it, but I feel like it's some things that you guys still need to work on before you guys really move forward. Even though they handled something, did something, and they're coming back to be, like, honest with you and stuff like that, I just feel like there was a reason why you guys broke up. And that needs to be kind of talked about, figured out, and stuff before you guys, you know, really move forward. So we have It Is Safe For You To Love, and we have Like Attracts Like. Let me see. If you are longing for more love in your life, you need to be more loving. Yeah, so somebody needs to show more love and be more loving in this situation. Okay, and I feel like that's what they're doing. And we have It Is Safe For You To Love. So open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all. So I feel like your heart may still be open to this. Or it's like they're fully going to open their heart to in a way that you've been wanting for some time. Like, so you're finally going to get what you want. They're finally going to express, tell you, come with this offer. So it's going to be great. Okay. So that does look good. January, February, March. Pisces. We have the Ten of Swords reverse. We have the Eight of Cups, and we have the Empress. So Pisces, some of you guys are moving on to bigger and better things. Some of you guys are definitely going towards commitment. Or the Empress is telling me that you guys are just doing a lot of self-healing. This is self-love, self-care, healing. Ten of Swords is in reverse. It looks like you guys are walking away from somebody, though. And when you walk away, you're going to go towards so much better. Because look, see on the Eight of Cups, it's a guy there. And he's like, she's walking away. Some of you guys are going to leave somebody in the middle of the night, or you're just walking away. You're just like, this is some bullshit. You're like, I'm tired of you. I'm tired of your bullshit. Tired of your drunk text. Tired of you just acting a fool, doing this, doing that. You know, you're like, I'm tired of you embarrassing me. You know, like, I'm done. Yeah, because you've been holding on and hanging on. So, and that's your energy, Pisces, with the Hangman. And you're done. Why is Eight of Cups here? But I'm telling you, like, the moment you walk away, it's like you're going towards bigger and better. All right, let's see for Pisces. Yep, see, you're going towards bigger and better. See, so from the 8 to the 10, the 8 is you walking away. And then it's like you're going towards your 10 of cups. So you're going towards something so much better. Something that's going to be so much, like, it's just going to be a lot more fulfilling, a lot more happier. Okay? So let's see what Pisces we have. Forgiving and learning. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love. And that's what you're doing. You're going to heal and release this situation and let go. Forgive them. Self-forgiveness. Move on. I guess accept what's going on in this situation. And then you're going towards your 10 of cups. Yep. Listen. Look. Listen with your heart. You are listening to what is being said to you, but need to listen with a loving heart. So people may have been telling you stuff And they're telling you this because they love you and that they care about you. They're not telling you this because they don't want to see you guys work out or they don't want to see this relationship work out. They're telling you this because you do deserve better and you deserve to be the Empress with this Ten of Cups energy, okay? And you guys are going to finally be open to it and just heal and release and move on. So, Pisces, I feel like you guys are kind of like going through some type of ending or will be soon, okay? June, February, March, April, Aries. We have the Two of Cups, we have the Ace of Pentacles, and we have the Three of Swords. So Aries, you guys are in the middle of a third party for some of you guys. We have the Two of Cups, a soulmate connection, and it's a commitment, or there's a relationship that you really want to be in, okay? But it's the Three of Swords here. Now, the Three of Swords, if it's not a third party, it's like this person is coming back offering commitment, but you're scared because there has been some heartbreak, there has been a third party, there has, you know, been this type of energy before. But let's go into the Three of Swords and see what this is about. Let's see, why is the Three of Swords here for Aries? We have the World card and we have the Nine of Pentacles. So somebody is ending a third party. A third party is coming to an ending with the World card and Nine of Pentacles. And now somebody is single and available and ready to be with you. And that can be what this is about. And they're coming in with this offer. Or you're breaking free from this third party and you're going to meet and attract your soulmate. And they're coming in like very soon. You're going to meet this person in the next couple months. Okay, if not sooner. So with that, we have flirts and we have appreciate this moment. Each and every situation has an opportunity to grow and find love. So you are appreciating this moment and what you went through in this situation, this third party, because now it's going to help you find, attract love or find the love that you want and need or have been looking for. It might also be helping you attract this soulmate. And it says extend your lighthearted energy to others. So Aries, I see you guys doing some flirting. Are you guys will be flirting with people? Okay. Are you been doing a lot of flirting? All right, so that's what I got for Aries. April, May, Taurus. We have the Chariot in reverse. You could be dealing with a Cancer, the Queen of Swords, and we have the Two of Wands. So Taurus, you are in a situation that you know is like not going anywhere, okay? And your sword is down, even though the Queen of Swords is here. And I feel like it's time for you to speak up and say something. I feel like you know that there's obstacles, blockages, stagnant energy. You know it's not going anywhere, but at the same time with the Chariot, it's in the Queen of Swords, it's kind of like you're not speaking up and saying anything. It's kind of like you're just kind of like settling and staying in the situation, even though you know you don't know where it's going, where it's headed, or you just know that it's not going anywhere. But then it's like at the same time, you don't want to give up. I feel like you keep saying that, you know, you're going to be done or you've been done, or maybe this is what you're telling yourself or telling people, but you're not doing anything about the situation. The sword is down with the Queen of Swords, okay? So it's kind of telling you like you have the upper hand in this. Like, you can do what you need to do or have to do in this situation, but you're not, okay? We have the Knight of Pentacles here. So you're giving it some time. It could be a Virgo you're dealing with. You're giving this situation some time to see if it's going to change. So I feel like that's what this is about. Why is the Knight of Pentacles here for Taurus? Yeah, you're giving it some time before you give up. I feel like you've been wanting to give up. You're heartbroken, you're torn, you're hurt, you've been crying, you've been dealing with a lot, but I feel like you're giving it some time before you fully give up on the situation. So it says getting to know each other. As you reveal your innermost selves to each other, your bond deepens. So I feel like that's the thing. Like, you know this person, or you've known them for a long time. Or, like, again, like I said, this is not something you want to give up on. But at the same time, you know it's not going anywhere, Taurus. And we have be willing to express love. When we express love, we begin to receive more love. So it's also saying, Taurus, you need to tell this person how you feel. But I feel like for some of you guys, you already have told this person how you feel. And I don't feel like anything is changing. So I feel like you guys definitely, that's why I see why you guys are feeling stuck. You're like, I don't want to give up on this. I told this person how I feel. I want to see if they're going to make some type of changes. The Knight of Pentacles is telling me that they are going to make some changes. But it's going to be like right when you're ready to give up is when things are going to start to change. Because it's the Knight of Pentacles. It takes forever. It moves very slow. Okay. So that's what I have for Taurus. Gemini. Happy birthday, Gemini. So we have the Hierophant, Taurus energy. We have the Ten of Pentacles. And we have the Knight of Pentacles. So Gemini, there is a relationship that is soon about to be a commitment, okay? I feel like you guys have met their family and friends. Or they met your family and friends. Or you guys, like you know their family or their family knows you. Or you guys have just been talking for a long time. And maybe it was like this moving very slow and it wasn't going anywhere. And now it's about to go somewhere, okay? Gemini, some of you guys are celebrating, maybe having like a big dinner or doing something with family and friends. And this person is coming. But I feel like this month, going into like next month, you guys are gonna make things official with somebody. Okay, so it looks like you guys are finally gonna go towards that relationship or be in some type of relationship with this person. Why is Knight of Pentacles here? Six of Wands are in reverse, and we have the Justice. Yeah, and I feel like the problem too was that I feel like the person you guys are dealing with, they get a lot of attention, or it's kind of like things kind of like failed between you guys in the past, or you felt like they just weren't focused on a relationship. And I feel like in the past they weren't, and it took them some time to come around. But it could be a Libra you guys are dealing with, but they're going to be open and honest with you about what they want. And what they want is like, they're going to be like, you know, we've been friends with benefits for so long, or we've been talking for so long, and I'm ready. So it's kind of like they're coming with the like, I'm ready finally, all of a sudden, like, I'm ready. So let's see. We have trust. This situation is calling for you to have faith. And then we have be authentic to who you are. You are asked to be real and true pertaining to who you are and how you feel. So I feel like, Gemini, this person has been wanting to be with you, but I feel like they just weren't being true and authentic and real when it came to like how they really felt. And they could have been telling you like, oh, I'm not ready, I don't want to be with you, this is not what I want, I'm not sure. But they were doing everything that speaks relationship. They were taking you out, coming over, buying you stuff, doing stuff for your kids, entertaining the family, coming over, like, what's up? Maybe even calling your family, like, their family, or hey, mom, all that type of stuff. They were doing all that. And that, to me, speaks relationship. But now they're ready. And deep down inside, they've been ready and been wanting this. But maybe they were afraid, okay? But they were trusting and hoping that this was going to work out, or maybe you were, okay? So, let's see. Cancer. We have the Knight of Wands. We have the King of Wands. And we have the Page of Swords reverse. Okay. So with the Knight of Wands, King of Wands, Page of Swords reverse, Cancer, this is someone that just can't seem to decide. Like, it's kind of like somebody that's on and off with a job. You know, like, one minute they want to do this, one minute they want to work here. Oh, I don't want to get up in the morning. Oh, I want a night job. Oh, I want to do this. So when it came to you, it's like one minute they were coming to see you, taking action, things are good. Then the next minute they were like really pursuing you. But then it's like they fell off and stopped doing that, and then stopped focusing on that. And then it's like they're back doing it again. So I brought that up to say that whoever you guys are dealing with, they were fickle. Like they were just, they didn't know. But it's like now it's like they really do want to pursue this after being confused for so long, because it goes from the Knight to the King. All right. So let's see. Why is the Page of Swords in reverse? Going to the Page of Swords in reverse. Why is the Page of Swords in reverse? We have Judgment, and we have, see, look, the King of Wands. They really, deep down inside, like I said, they really wanted to pursue this, okay? And we have the Five of Swords, but they were just on some bullshit, and I feel like the bullshit was them. Like, and it's, and I'm not saying it like this, Cancer. I feel like they've been knew that you guys could have been together, made this happen or whatever, but they were the ones being difficult. They were the ones being petty and difficult. I just feel petty when I see the Five of Swords. And you guys could have been dealing with a Sagittarius heavy, okay? That's what I'm getting. Let's pull your love cards. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. And then we have take a chance on love. See, that's what they're doing. When you start to love, our lives are changed forever. So they're taking a chance on love. And they see that even though they were back and forth and acting funny, you still fuck with them. And so now they're like, all right, I'm going to take a chance on it. Because Cancer, you know, I've been playing these games, bullshitting Cancer, doing this and that. So I'm going to still give it. I'm going to take a chance. I'm going to do it. And we have 5, 23, 5. So something is changing about the situation. So they're going to go from this back and forth, on and off energy to like really like trying to pursue you, taking you out, buying you stuff, doing stuff for you. And you're going to be like, where did this energy come from? You know what I'm saying? And it's not going to be bad. Like, I don't, it's going to be a good change. But it's going to shock you. Okay, Cancer? Let's see what's going on with my Leos. From the Swords reverse, we have the Ace of Cups, and we have the Strength card. So you thought a motherfucker was lying, Leo, when they told you that they loved you and that they wanted to be with you and build and have something with you. You thought they were lying through their teeth, but you're seeing that they're not. Like, if the strength card is your energy, Leo, and it's telling me that there's a lot of love here. You guys have a strong connection, or it's like you guys got what it takes. Like, you guys are going to get through this. You guys are going to make it happen. They're not lying when they told you that they love you. I feel like they were being secretive and not telling you certain things, but it's like they're showing you love and expressing love to you. And they're giving you a lot of love and a lot of attention. So let's see, Seven of Swords reverse. Okay, so they were lying to you at first, I feel, or they were lying to you for a minute because they felt stuck and they didn't want no trouble with you. They didn't want things to get worse, or they didn't want things to, like, I wouldn't say escalate, but the Six of Swords reverse can be like where somebody's senses are feels trouble, or they feel like if they tell you the 100% truth. Like, you might trip out, or things may not move forward no more. You know, like, our, you know, like, the relationship just won't be at peace because it'll be drama, because you're upset, because you're mad, or it could be them. But let's see. See, we have a fool. So they really did want this new beginning with you, or they really did want to start new. I feel like you are their new beginning. I feel like this is a new relationship you're going into or stepping into. So they lied to you in the beginning because they didn't want to get cut off. All right. Let's see. We have finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. For some of you guys, finances are an issue, okay? Somebody may cannot bring as much money to the table as they want to, or they're dealing with a lot of financial problems and issues, and that can be another reason why they lied to you, okay? But they wanted this relationship to be built off love and not, like, what they can and cannot do, etc. for some of you guys. And then we have, this is the reverse. We have number 38, which is 11, which breaks down to 1, and the guys wearing a mask. So look, honesty is essential. To be a loving person, it is important that we speak truthfully in a loving manner. So it's like they were kind of, whoever this was, they were wearing a mask, Leo. But I feel like they were being honest with you when they told you what they want with you and their feelings, but they weren't being honest about a financial situation or a situation they were getting out of, okay? And now they're being honest and speaking truthfully to you. I see a wedding dress here. So some of you guys, it's going to be marriage coming in, okay? So that's what I'm getting for Leo. Let's see what's going on with Virgo. Two of Swords came first. We have the Moon and the King of Cups. So Virgo, somebody is following their hearts, okay? This person could have made a head over heart decision in the past, and they are no longer confused, okay? They are open to this. This person is definitely, there's a lot of love around this situation. If there was two people, they cut somebody off. Let's see why the Moon is here. We got Pisces energy. We have, yeah, see, we have the Two of Swords. It was somebody else involved. Ooh, the Devil. Let me pull one more card on this, Virgo. The Wands. And I feel like they were trying to move out of this situation. Something that had, like, something that was controlling them. So they could have just been in, like, a toxic or karmic situation. This person could have been, like, controlling them, confusing them in their head. Somebody could have even did, like, some spell work, some black magic or something to kind of, like, block somebody. Okay? But if they did, they're coming out of it. Meaning, like, they're coming out of whatever was put on them, or they're coming out of, like, this dark energy or this toxic or karmic relationship with somebody. All right? And they're definitely following their heart. They made a head over heart decision in the past. Let's see. Yeah, we have reconciliation with focus on love. So someone from your past is returning. This can be someone from your past, or it's just telling me that you guys are going to work things out. So it says focus on love. Look for the good attributes in each and every person in your life. So they're ready to focus on love. They feel like you are a good attribute and that you bring good and positive energy into their life. All right? And I feel like you guys have definitely helped them out in some type of way. Okay? So that looks good. What comes after Virgo, y'all? September, October, Libra. The Fortune reverse, the Six of Wands, the Ten of Cups. Libra, don't look back. Don't look back, Libra. We have the Wheel of Fortune in reverse with the Six of Wands and the Ten of Cups. I'm telling you, things are going to look so much better if you don't look back. The Wheel of Fortune in reverse is like a stagnant energy. It's like you're not moving forward. And I feel like you want success and victory and love. You want fulfillment. You want your Ten of Cups. You want that love. You want that energy. You want to feel like, you want to know what that feels like. But it's telling you, like, don't look back. It could be a Sagittarius that is holding you back, but it's saying don't look back. Once you stop looking back, you're going to go towards everything that you've been wanting and trying to manifest in love. So with the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, we have the Five of Pentacles. Look, see, he told you, as soon as you don't look back, things are going to look up and look better right away. Yep, see, the Seven of Wands in reverse. It's not about calling quits and giving up. It's about letting go. No longer putting that fight up. No longer fighting. You know, no longer putting that energy into it. I feel like it was a fire sign. Yeah, see, because this person was selfish anyway. It was one-sided. You know, they were all about themselves. This person was also taking advantage, okay, in a way, using you in a way, Libra. And now it's time for you guys to come out of that energy. So we have chemistry. There's a strong magnetic attraction here. And we have act as if your partner is here. What did I tell you, Libra? So you're going to meet somebody and there's going to be a lot of chemistry. And it says, whether you have someone in your life or not, act as if they are with you so you will always consider them. So let me see what this is about, Libra. See the Nine of Swords. And I feel like the person that is in your life that you have chemistry with, sometimes I feel like you really want this, but they stress you, they annoy you, they frustrate you. There's a lot of like sleepless nights, a lot of hurt and everything. And what the universe is trying to say is like, it's not worth it and it's not them. You need to act as if your person is here. Whoever you're trying to manifest, whatever kind of love you're trying to bring into your life, Libra, it's going to be after you stop looking back. Because with the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, it's just not the right time. The timing is off. It's a karmic relationship. You're calling the karmic cycle. You're in a karmic cycle with this person. Or it's just not moving forward. And you know that. Okay? So, let's see. Libra, October, November, Scorpio, then Sag, right? Yep, Scorpio. We have the Ace of Swords in reverse, the High Priestess in reverse, and the Devil, Scorpio. Your intuition is blocked. Like, don't, you're getting lied to and played and manipulated right now. Okay? Somebody is a snake around you. Please be careful, Scorpio. All right? Be careful. All right? Could be a Capricorn or a Pisces, but somebody is lying and being very deceptive right now. All right? And your intuition is blocked. And I feel like you're just like, kind of like, no, they would never do that to me. No, it's not like that. No, I don't believe this. No, I don't believe that. And I'm not trying to change my voice to be funny. I'm saying, like, for real. Like, I feel like when it comes to this person, you really are just like, no, that wouldn't happen. They wouldn't do that to me. You know, it's that kind of energy. But they're lying like a motherfucker and keeping secrets. You may even be their secret. And we have the Devil here, okay? So they, and it's like, you see how they're, this person is trapped in this cage? I feel like this person has you right where they want you, okay? Look, see, the Moon is in reverse. Some type of secret affair, some type of secret. All right, let's see. Why is the High Priestess in reverse for Scorpio? We have the Chariot, could be a Cancer. And we have Temperance. So, give me one more card. We have the Four of Pentacles. Yeah, see, somebody has you holding on, telling you to be patient, or telling you that they can only see you at certain times. And it's because they have a commitment or a relationship. Okay? Some of you guys see something in their car, or you guys will see something in their car. Give me a little bit more information for Scorpio. We have the Five of Cups in reverse and the King of Pentacles. They're telling you that they have moved on from somebody and they haven't. They're still committed to that person. And the thing is that they reconcile with this person, Scorpio, and that's the problem. Could be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. That's what they aren't telling you. So for Scorpio, we have make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you are guided to take. And then we have the Union of Hearts. There is a connection of love that defies explanation. So if that's the case, then that means that you guys may be caught up in some type of twin flame connection, or a connection that is meaningful. There's a union here, and it doesn't have to be twin flame. It could be soulmate, whatever, you know, the title of your relationship. So it's a strong connection, spiritual connection, but you just keep going through shit with this person. Okay? And it's like, I'm not going to say I don't know what to say about this, but I'm just going to tell you that eventually they're going to make the effort and get to this relationship. But we have number 28, which is a 10. I feel like this year with this person, you're at your, like, this is your year of endings with them. So I feel like a lot of stuff may be ending for them. You guys keep getting back together, breaking up, whatever. But it's like the new beginning, the new cycle is going to start for you guys next year. I don't know why I feel that, but that's what I'm feeling. We have the Seven of Cups, and we have the Six of Swords, and we have the Magician, which is one. And I feel like for the rest of this year, or just for the rest of this month, just moving forward, I feel like there's going to be a lot of confusion. And I feel like one minute you're going to be at peace and think things are great and happy, and then you're going to be back confused and hurt and like, oh, well, what's going on? I thought you said this. I thought you said that. And they can definitely change the situation and make things happen, but they're not doing it. So you're going to be going through a lot of ups and downs or endings with this person this year. Okay? One month you're good. One month you're not. Is what I'm getting for some of you guys, Scorpio, okay? But there is a strong connection here. And what's lacking or missing, or what's messing this up, is that they're not making or putting the effort into it, okay? Last but not least, Sag. We have the Star in reverse, Aquarius. We have the Sun, Leo. And we have the Hangman. So I feel like there's either an Aquarius or a Leo in your life. Well, you guys might have two people in your life. One makes you really happy. One, you're just starting to lose hope and faith. You don't know what to do. But if not, it's like there is an Aquarius, or it could be any sign that's in your life, and you're starting to lose hope and faith in the situation. But you really want happiness, and you want a lot of fulfillment, and you just want joy, and you want to be content, and you want to move forward. But the hangman is here, so you've been holding on and waiting. All right, for some of you guys, you're letting or allowing a love situation to pass you up or pass you by because you're holding on to this situation. All right, you guys have the Sun here, love coming in. There could possibly be a child involved and everything. You know, but you're still holding on to this situation. Why is this the Star in reverse? The Knight of Cups. Yeah, you're waiting for somebody to come towards you, reconcile, apologize, offer some type of proposal, far as like commitment. Doesn't mean like engagement, but you want them to propose something to you. All right, with the Knight of Cups and the King of Pentacles. And then we have the Hangman. Let me see something really quick. Why is this here for Sagittarius? The High Priestess and the Ten of Pentacles. But your intuition is telling you not to hold on, because your intuition is telling you that every time you hold on, or for all these years that you've been holding on, you still have not got commitment. You still haven't got anything out of it. You still haven't. And this is what you want. You know, this is what you want. So the Star Reverse is telling me they're not getting that with the Knight of Cups and the King of Pentacles. So you got to ask yourself, is this worth even holding on to? We have the Queen of Pentacles and we have the Nine of Pentacles. I see a relationship or a commitment coming in with somebody else that can lead to a child and something serious where there's a commitment. But as long as you hold on to this, you're not going to know, because you're not going to be open to this new love coming in. So let's see, Sagittarius. Yeah, we have unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. And I don't feel like there's no chemistry or attraction here. That could be the thing, but I feel like the love is just unrequited. It's like you're hoping for or wanting something and you're just not going to get it, or you're not getting it right now. And we have turn on your heart light. See, allow yourself in this moment to reflect on the time when you experienced love. When have you really experienced love with this person? Just think about it, Sag. When is the last time you really experienced or had some form of love, or just felt love or loved by this person without it feeling or being unrequited? Okay, so don't say, oh, they came back to me last month and everything was good, but it was still third party. That's not experiencing love. That's experiencing bullshit. Okay, so when have they came back, or when have they come to you and gave you a loving experience to where you're just like, it just felt like, oh, like it was great. Every time I feel like they come to you, it's with unrequited love. They're on and off. They're lying. It's third party. They're not ready. It's good for the moment. Then it ends. You know, they're hot. They're cold. They don't know. They're not sure. Oh, you'll always be the love of my life. I'm going to marry you one day. That is all unrequited love. Someone that is just not sure. They don't know. Okay. See, turn on your heart like the Hermit in reverse. They always leave you in sadness, depression. Should I move on? What should I do? You know what I'm saying? So definitely think about that, Sagittarius, all right? Because like I said, with the Sun and this Queen of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, commitment, and somebody that is stable, somebody that has money, security, stability, that wants a child, somebody that is going to be there and give you that loving experience, all right? So that is what I have for you guys for the weekend, the reading and all the signs, all right? I hope you guys enjoyed the reading. And I will see you guys probably tomorrow, if not on Monday. If it resonated, please do like, share, comment, subscribe, hit that bell. If you guys would love to book with me, and the only way to book with me is on my website, fireintuition.com. If you guys would love to purchase the June box, you guys can go to my website, mytearsavehealedmyheart.com. All right? I love you guys. I love you, fire fam. Stay dope. And I'll see you guys, if not tomorrow, on Monday. Bye, loves.